why I chose to homeschool. Hello, you all. I'm Diana Breanne. And I got to thinking about my journey with homeschool. Why did I choose to homeschool my three children? And I was thinking back about my journey of homeschool. Well, first of all, I want to tell you that all three of my children have graduated high school and they are all doing wonderful and in college. So why did I homeschool them and how did I homeschool them? Well, my journey with homeschool started when my youngest was in kindergarten, my middle one was in first grade, and my oldest was in second grade. And we were living way down in Texas, and I had met a woman who had homeschooled in the 90s when it was unheard of, and she did very well with her son. Her son has grown up to be an amazing individual. And so I thought, well, you know what? I love my kids. I think I can do a great job homeschooling. And so I joined a homeschool group. I pulled my kids out of public school and they thrived. They absolutely thrived. And so I homeschooled all three. At home, we used to homeschool in the yard, the front yard, in the backyard, and in the car. We used to homeschool while we were in the car, going on field trips. I mean, it was wonderful. We bought a motorhome and we traveled, and my children learned as they went, you know, and I had books and resources. And back then, we didn't have a lot of online help like we do now, but we did have some. And so I loved my journey of homeschool. But then on and off, I put my kids back in public school. And then one by one, I would pull them out. You know, it depended upon the school and upon the need and why. Sometimes I homeschooled one, sometimes I homeschooled all three, and sometimes I just homeschooled two. And so there were reasons behind it. And it was a good choice for me. So fast forward a few years and we made another move to another state. And two of my children went back to public school, which I still think one of them I should have kept and homeschooled, but I didn't. But she turned out really, really well. And but I just think I would have liked to have homeschooled her versus send her back to traditional school. And but my youngest, I pulled him out in eighth grade and I homeschooled him and through the 12th grade. Although it was initially I started off with homeschool because in this state we didn't have a virtual public school. Right after I pulled him out, they came out with the virtual public school, the online school. And so, which is like homeschool, but it's technically public school and you get teachers and all the bells and whistles and you have proms and you also get to go on field trips and you interact with teachers. And so it's not just you teaching your child, in this case, like traditional homeschool that I did in the beginning. You have a big network of support. And then you get a regular public school diploma at the end of the line and a formal graduation. And so I did that with my youngest son from ninth grade. I homeschooled him in eighth and put him in the virtual school when it opened up in our state from ninth grade through 12th grade. And I mean, it was stressful at times because it wasn't our own curriculum and our own schedule. So would I have done the public online school or the homeschool looking back all the way through? I don't know. I think the quality of education that he got through the public online school was fantastic. Through homeschool, it was more relaxed. We could go at our own pace. It was less stressful. So I don't know, but both were wonderful. And so I'm glad that I did. And my youngest son, who graduated through the virtual online school, and I had to be here pretty much to supervise, just like I would in regular homeschool. He graduated and he's in college and doing wonderful. And he has all kinds of friends and he had all kinds of groups that he was involved with. So he didn't lack social you know, interaction or anything like that. And we were able to pick and choose his friends. He was able to pick and choose his friends rather than be shoved up in a classroom setting with people maybe he didn't want to be with. And yet he learned how to interact with all kinds of people, all types of people. And he's just an amazing, amazing person. So homeschool, virtual public school, you know, I think they're both wonderful and they give a person an option. And I'm so glad that I did it. When I first started off, I felt like I was jumping off a cliff. And it was scary. It was scary. Actually, every time I ever did it, it was kind of scary because you're on your own in many ways when you're homeschooling. When you're with a virtual public school, you've got to adapt to everything that you don't normally have to adapt to with your child when it goes to traditional school, because you're responsible. You're the learning coach with the virtual online schools. So both are a little bit like jumping off a cliff for me, but they were both wonderful and I'm so glad that we did it. So I wanted to share my journey of homeschooling with you, and I hope you subscribe to my page, to my channel. From my house to yours, God bless you, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.